Tēnei wā, kei runga I te whenua o Kai Pako Pako, ko oku whenua tūpuna. We're on a whenua called Kai Pako Pako, my great-great-grandfather's whare. Tamati Whanganui was his name, and he was Koko Ted's grandfather. Tamati Whanganui was a prisoner, a parihaka prisoner, who was sent to Otako. And so he was a pretty resilient man. He was sent there when he was 18 years old. This is Koko Ted's tūranga waiwai, so to speak. His father, Pehimana, farmed this land. All of this land, Kai Pako Pako, was a part of our whānau land, and still is today. When Koro Pehimana was here at the homestead, he started dairy farming. I think he started with about 7 cows. At that time, that were all hand-milked and put in milk cans and taken to the local dairy factory. And this is where Koko Ted learnt to milk and learnt to farm. As well as the 7 cows that were being milked, had huge market gardens.
This is where Koro had his cows, 7 cows, bale shed. Part of the concrete foundation is still here. The whole area was market gardening, flowers for market as well.
So very fond memories of Dad. He was very gentle, always smiling, happy, very hardworking. If we wasn't on the farm, we'd be at a marae somewhere. It was a partnership. It was Mum and Dad. So Dad was away a lot. You know, we all had to pull our weight. Milking cows, digging thistles, haymaking, feeding out.
The first time he won in 1965, I think he had about a herd of probably about 150 odd, and he'd amalgamated so many land blocks together. And then when he won in 1971, at that time it was sort of 6 kind of smaller farm units under one big farming operation, and he probably had a herd of over 200 at that time. And then by the time he retired, it was between sort of 350, 400 herd of cows that he had. Because I think he was only the third person to have won the trophy twice. And so they had a big celebration. That trophy was presented at Owai Marae. That's our Matua Tiatiawa Marae. But then a little bit later, they brought a big celebration to Murudaupatu. Brought together our kapahaka, his very good friend and whanaunga, Uncle Charlie Bailey, was there too, who had also won it twice. And so it was a really big deal for the whole whānau. So we're not dairy farming, but we're still absolutely on our whenua.
This homestead is part of the Papakainga, where my father was born and bred and lived for the whole of his life. He was sent to St. Stephen's. As much as he wanted to stay there, life became hard for my grandmother and grandfather on the farm. He was brought home probably around the age of 14, and from then on he ran the farm with the help of his siblings. And a lot of people came to this homestead. So it was a big part of his life, and we still have this as a Ahuwhenua trust. So he was quite the man about town. He was musical and he was a great dancer. One lady who came to visit, she caught his eye, and her name was Hene Marie Tirikatene. And in 1950, they were married. Mum and Dad had 3 other children. Unfortunately, our mum passed at the age of 32. Dad was a very service-minded person, I guess. He had a duty to work for the people. Dad was an entrepreneur. We had 700 pigs at its peak. He was also into racehorses, and he would train the racehorses and take them down to Trentham. The West Coast leases became more important nationally, and Dad and other Māori leaders felt that something had to be done to safeguard the land. They formed the first committee of Parinenihi Ki Waitotara Incorporation. And of course, another recipient of the Ahuwhenua Trophy was Ted Tamati. He was also part of the first committee. So this was part of their vision, to stop the fragmentation of land blocks in Taranaki.
Well, when he started off, he farmed his family land of 9.7 hectares, And then he slowly bought out the neighbours and then ended up with about 240 acres. So I actually remember him coming down to the cowshed and saying, I had a dream that everybody was shaking my hand. And he said, I wonder what that means. And of course, then he found out that he had won it. And in his newspaper article, he quoted that he couldn't have won the trophy without the help of his family, with us girls helping him all those years. I was actually away teaching. That's when he won the trophy again, and they had the presentation at Parihaka. Leon and I have been very involved in the farm since Dad died in 1987.
He had to go and check on some work that was being done at the Parihaka farms, and he wasn't well, and he was walking across the whenua, and he had a massive heart attack. So he died at Parihaka, which is fitting for his wakapapa to Parihaka.